Ladies and gentlemen, he's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
And good morning, America. It is Wednesday as we approach the Christmas vacation. Welcome to the Patriot Radio Show. I'm your host, Tom O'Halloran, and I'm here to exercise my white privilege. I'm broadcasting today from my underground bunker deep in Arcantana, Brascarado, and I'm here to educate, irritate, and agitate. And folks, if you're not fully agitated by the time this show's over, you just ain't listening. Again, my name is Tom O'Halloran. My primary blog, TomOHalloran.com. You can find us on Facebook. We're at Facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. And personally, I'm at Facebook.com/O'Halloran. We're kind of winging it this morning. If one of my regular co-hosts would like to call in, you're welcome to do it. I was expecting my Wednesday morning co-host, Jen Hamam, a.k.a. Ms. Mayhem, to call in. And we had a special show prepared for you. Prepared more as in a concept, a direction that we were going to go and have a conversation. And I've done enough research to carry up my end of this conversation, but not so much as to carry on and do a whole show on my own. So if somebody wants to call in, we're going to be talking about their 17 national security agencies that have now come forward and said that the Russians were involved with this. Well, Jen said the other night, she said, why do we even have 17 security agencies? How many of them are even constitutional? So we're going to have a conversation about this today, and I'm only semi-prepared to go forward with this. So again, if Mike or Bill want to give a call in, we can deal with this. Mike, it looks like Bill's deferring to you. So if you're up for it, give me a holler. If not, we'll stumble through this and call it a short show if we have to do that. But at any rate, folks, we do this show 5 times a week, whether we have a show or not. 5 times. Tune in every Monday through Thursday. It's 9 a.m. Texas time for this, the Patriot Radio Show. On Fridays, same bat time, same bat channel, we do Jihad on America. Here we cover the Islamists in America, sharing with you who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show Islam is Not a Religion, or my show on Islamophobia, then please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com. Listen to all 3 of these shows for insight and perspective on the Islamic topic that you've probably not heard elsewhere. The shows will also give you a solid foundation upon which we build each and every Friday as we continue to pull back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And I do the news about Islam around the world because it's a glimpse into the future of what's in store for us here in the homeland if we continue to allow the cancer of Islam to spread. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as catch up on the archives of any shows you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. This show is rebroadcast daily at ConfederateBroadcasting.com, at ConservativeRadioNetwork.com, at LibertyWorks Radio Network, and at RedNationRising.us. Mike, you're dialing the wrong number, brother. I'm staring at my phone. It's not ringing. You can also take the show on the road with you by using your iPhone or Android. There it goes. Phone is now ringing. Phone is now being answered.
Hello?
Brother, are you there?
I am here.
Hey, brother. Welcome to the show. You can also
By
my request. You can also take the show on the road with you with your Android or iPhone just by downloading the TuneIn app and doing a search for The Patriot Radio Show. Well, brother, I appreciate you picking up the phone and calling in.
You bet.
It's unheard of for Jen to do this. She's usually pretty...
Well, maybe some emergency came up or something.
It may well have. It may well have. Because we talked just two nights ago. She sends me a text and she says, everybody's talking about these 17 security agencies are all in agreement that Russia is behind the hacks. Well,
okay. 17, where have I been?
Yeah, right? And that's what was her question. Why isn't anybody questioning why we even have 17 security agencies? So we're going to talk about that today. I briefed myself to be able to carry on a semi-intelligent conversation, which is about the level I usually do. And I was ready for that, but I was kind of expecting to bounce it back and forth with her, and appreciate you calling in and stepping up for that. So
I've always got a hutch of rabbits to unleash for you.
Yeah, right. Rabbit hole here, rabbit hole there. So this is our National Security Agency show, folks. That may be the last time you hear us talking about national security agencies, since my co-host today is Mike Rabbit Hole. Today we are down to 29 days, 13 hours, and 52 minutes until this siege of Barack Hussein Obama is over, and we are once again a free people.
I've heard he's trying to flush through a whole bunch more Islamist refugees into the country before he scoots out the door.
Yep, he released another Gitmo guy yesterday, or early this morning, I think it may have been, and it was a real bad guy, one of the chief bad guys out of Iran, if I'm not mistaken. But, anything that he can do to hurt the country.
Well, the scorched earth policy.
Right. Yeah, that's...
As he's leaving, going out the door.
Well, we're going to have a massive flood. We're down to 29 days. We're going to see a massive flood of pardons and commutations. He's already, as I mentioned yesterday, he's already pardoned or commuted the sentences of 1,100 and something people, which is probably three times as many as the last 11 presidents all combined. And he's just hitting the pardon season, because it's usually the last couple, 2 to 3 weeks where this stuff starts really hitting.
Well, Tom, if he's in the mood to do that, I'd be calling the White House. My wife has a parking ticket.
You can get it waived real quick. No. You married a white girl.
Oh, shoot. That's right.
So she's got to be an illegal, a transgender, a Muslim, or a black to get this kind of a pardon. Or an illegal alien.
She came off the farm, too, so that's doubly bad.
No, she's screwed. You better just mortgage the tractor. Now, before we get into the show that may or may not even happen, because neither one of us are really prepared for this. Well, we'll get to it, folks. We will talk about the National Security Agency.
We'll wing it.
But we're really not feeling the pressure right now. MTV did an ad the other day. Have you seen the ad?
Oh, yes. And thank God, I just posted something on the chat room about how the it's being removed. The ad, you know, the New Year's resolution for white guys.
Here was an ad. It was a bunch of young black Mexican, mostly women and effeminate men, telling the white men, here's what you need to do for the 2017. Them giving us advice. Advice for white men. So here was my reply on Facebook. Dear MTV, I just saw your ad offering advice for white men. Newsflash, we don't need advice. We are both white and men. All we need to do is exist and exercise our white privilege. Apology accepted. After all, how could you understand? You are neither white nor men. Do you think that might have wound him up just a little bit? Here's the thing, folks, okay? You asshats lost the frickin' election. Losers don't give advice, okay? The white men won the election, okay? Everybody's trying to say that it's only the white men that Trump got to vote for, and that was started by Bill Clinton. So we're gonna run with that. White men won this election, so it's up to us now to give you advice. Okay, so stay tuned in coming weeks when we start giving advice to black men, to black women, to the Latino community. Dear Latino community, here's what you need to do for 2017. Yeah, it's going to be fun. I'm going to enjoy the heck out of 2017.
Well, Tom, let's not forget, a lot of blacks and Latinos came over on the Trump side and voted for him.
I know they did.
And the black rabble-rousers and Latino rabble-rousers can't figure out why that happened.
Oh, no, they figured it out. They're just Uncle Toms. That's right. Because anytime you're not going to cry and stay on the welfare plantation, you got to be an Uncle Tom. So,
heavens, let's call the wambulance.
Right. Now, you're absolutely right. And the ones that came across and voted for Trump understand when I say, dear black Americans, here's what you need to do. They understand, okay? They get what I'm talking about. And they know that it isn't just white men that voted for Trump. Trump could not have gotten into office if every white man in America got out and voted.
That's just Democrat talking points is all that is. That's
all it is. They're trying to marginalize Donald Trump. They cried for a recount. They lost that. They cried for the electoral vote. They lost that. They're probably going to recount the electoral vote now. They'll lose that too. How many times can Hillary lose this damned election anyway? So it's been a fun ride. I've enjoyed it. And I'm still enjoying it. I had another one the other day. Let me see if I can scroll back and find that. Talking about unleashing on these idiots. Somebody was complaining about Trumpsters, and I let this guy have it as well. I don't usually type stuff on Facebook. You've seen my stuff. I do my memes. I broadcast, and that way I can say the same thing over and over and over again without ever having to retype. So I create my memes, and they're more...
entertaining.
There's some entertainment.
Informative.
There's some of that to them as well. But it's more of a broadcast media. I don't get into Facebook to debate and get into arguments. You know, Ken Crow was real big on getting onto his page and arguing with people and stuff. I'm not here to argue with people.
Hey Tom, I saw that thing you posted here the other day about your little chat with that person. You remember what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I got a kick out of that.
Did you like that? I'll go over that.
Yes, I did.
I'll go over that. I read that to somebody yesterday. I wasn't sure whether it was here or where. Okay, here we go. This is another one where I just unleashed. Somebody said, and it was on somebody else's page, and it was such a good, hard, if I can say that to myself, my own stuff. A good hard hit to the guy that I just went ahead and did a screenshot and posted it out into the general stream of my timeline. This guy named Scott Sykes made the comment, "You trampsters are idiots. The uneducated idiots." So I said, okay. "And you that lost the election, the losers, are a bunch of whiny, sniveling, crybaby pussies. We can always go back to school and get another degree, but you will always be assholes. Suck it up, fucktard. It's a brand new day in America." So I may have been too mamby-pamby. I may not have gotten my feelings and attitude across to him. My wife says I have issues with being clear and concise about what I'm trying
to
say.
Tom, you got to learn to take the gloves off, man.
Right. Stop sugarcoating everything I'm trying to say.
Yeah, really.
Yeah, she says
this. But that's the only way these liberals get anything down, you know.
Right.
You know, they got to have their puppy dogs and coloring books and Play-Doh and that sort of thing. And
it's all about,
you know,
it's all about the feelings. Okay, I'm going to do one more Facebook thing, the one you were commenting on, and then we'll get into some real topic. So here's a conversation.
All right.
Here's a conversation I had with somebody the other day. And he says, "Oh God, you're a Republican, aren't you?" I said, "Well, I worked for the Trump campaign for the last 6 months of the election." He said, "How disappointing." I said, "I mean, we can still grab a bite and get a beer. You know, I actually enjoy discussing politics with people I disagree with." The guy says, "I'm undocumented, and you worked for a campaign that promised to deport me. So, no." I said, "Well, I mean, we could talk at least before you leave, right?" "Yeah, you're leaving, but I'll still talk to you till then." Oh, I just love winding these idiots up.
Well, that's when you excuse yourself and go away, like to go to the bathroom or something, and come back later and talk with him and say, "Oh, by the way, when I was gone, I called ICE to report you."
Right.
Oh, better be here waiting outside.
Right. That next knock on your door. Oh, mercy, mercy.
Oh, hey, Bill posted something interesting here in the chat.
Well, that's
Texas officially removes Medicaid funding from Planned Parenthood.
Outstanding. Outstanding.
Breitbart.
Outstanding. Well, you know, there's lots of reasons to be proud to be in Texas, and that's just one more to the list. That's just one more to the list. So that was my thing for the week. The two political hits, and I rarely get in and actually type something to somebody in Facebook. But those two, here's my typical thing, and you know, I typed a few of them into the chat room this morning. Links to them anyway, because Bill doesn't go on Facebook at all, so he has no idea what I do out there. But here's my typical Facebook post. Do you ever wake up, kiss the person next to you, and whisper, "I want you, now," and just feel happy to be alive? I did that the other day. And today my lawyer called, and it turns out I'll never be allowed on Spirit Airlines again. So I just post kind of weird stuff to get people to say, "Huh? Did he really say that? Could he be serious?" So anyway, we've got some security agencies. And this is a good thing, right? We should have...
I didn't know we had that many.
We should have security agencies, but I would think, you know, an agency would do. Or maybe two.
You know, like what they say, is too many cooks spoil the soup.
Yeah, right? And
you know, I mean... Are they working together or against each other?
And we're going to go. We're going
all
to go,
writing for funding.
We're going to go through the list on this and kind of a synopsis of what they do, and you'll see some overlapping. Picture yourself with a baseball team, and you've got five center fielders. Right? Who's going to get that one bit of information? Who's going to catch the ball? I got it. No, I got it. Nobody really knows who's going to get it. And if they get it, are they going to share it? So there's a great deal of confusion, if you will, with all these sub-agencies having their own intelligence services. For example, there's one that's inside, an intelligence agency inside the State Department. and we'll get to them as soon as we come back from the break. I do want to take the break now so that when we come back, we can get straight on this. Get your recorder ready, brother, okay? We're going to do the one that you're looking for.
All right.
Okay, we're going to do the Old Spice ad. Folks, stick around. It is the Patriot Radio Show on a Wednesday morning. It's like 3 out of 3 this week. I usually pride myself on having good, solid, tight, informative shows. This week, you know what? I'm 0 for 3, my friends. 0 for 3. And largely, it's the fault or thanks to my friends in the chat room throwing stuff at me. Like Carol Pillow there, refugee resettlement. Oh, here we go. Stick around, folks.
Watch out. Watch out. Watch out for
cigarette hangover.
That stale, musty, smoked-out taste in your mouth.
Cigarette hangover.
That tight, dry, uncomfortable feeling in your throat.
Cigarette hangover.
That's what takes the joy out of smoking. And when that happens to you, it's time to switch to Philip Morris. Remember,
over 2 million more smokers have switched to Philip Morris.
Yes, if you're tired of cigarette hangover, join the millions who have discovered in Philip Morris a milder smoke, a cleaner, fresher smoke than they've ever known before.
Over 2 million more smokers have switched to Philip Morris.
Remember, Philip Morris is the one, the only cigarette proved definitely less irritating, proved definitely milder than any other leading brand. No other cigarette can make that statement.
Remember, top-ranking doctors, eminent nose and throat specialists, actually suggest Philip Morris in cases of irritation due to smoking.
Above all, remember this. You'll be glad tomorrow you smoked Philip Morris today.
You'll be glad this winter you bought a Coleman heater this fall. Yes, as you sit back in your easy chair, snug and comfortable, you'll be glad you bought a Coleman heater. You'll enjoy floor-to-ceiling warmth in those rooms you could never heat before.
Get your Coleman oil or gas heater now during Coleman's big bonus sale. Here's what you get.
First bonus, a new low price.
Yes, now you can get a dependable Coleman automatic heater at a new low price.
Second bonus, a new low operating cost.
Coleman saves you up to 25% on heating bills because Coleman gives you maximum heat from your fuel.
Third bonus, a 32-piece set of Libby's Safe Edge glassware worth $14. It's free with your new Coleman heater.
Get three big bonuses. Get your Coleman oil or gas heater now during Coleman's big bonus sale. This sale is for a limited time only.
So see your Coleman dealer tomorrow. You'll find his name and address in your telephone directory.
Lyman Abner will be with us in just a moment. But first, a short message from the Ford dealers of America. Owners everywhere are talking about the economy of the 50 Ford. Listen to what Mr. Jacob N. Wade of Lyndhurst, Virginia, one of over 420,000 delighted owners, said about his new Ford.
In these days when the cost of everything is up, it's certainly great to own a 50 Ford. For I found that my new Ford V8 gives me everything I'd expect to find in an expensive car for amazingly little money. And in addition to being a low-cost car to buy, I find my Ford is mighty economical to own. I get 20 miles to a gallon and spend very little for upkeep. My money sure goes a lot further since I've owned a 50 Ford. Yes, Ford owners everywhere are finding out about the economy of the great new Ford. They're saving real money now because of Ford's low price. And they'll be saving real money for years to come because of Ford's low operating and maintenance costs. But see for yourself. Tomorrow, stop by your neighborhood Ford dealers. Get the facts on Ford economy. Then take the wheel and test drive the big new Ford.
Every one of you undoubtedly has a headache or pain remedy that you swear by. But haven't you noticed that on some occasions it fails you? That there are times it does not seem to work? On these occasions, let me suggest that you try Anacin, for here is a remedy that I'm sure won't fail you. You'll find the fastest and most complete relief in Anacin you have ever experienced. The reason is simple. Anacin contains not one pain-soothing agent alone, but four, one of which is in all probability the remedy you now customarily take to relieve pain. You can get Anacin at your druggist for a few cents. Your money back if you're not pleased. I'll spell the name. A-N-A-C-I-N.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, brushless or lather, boys, whichever use the notion.
50 cents for shaving cream, $1 for the lotion.
Full
Advice means quality, said the captain to the bosun. So look for the package with the ship that sails the ocean. Yo-ho, yo-ho.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America, one voice, united we stand. I am America, one hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done. I will not rest until we won. I am America.
And we are back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Wednesday morning, and I got a text during the break from our dear friend Jen Haybam. She had a family emergency and just in the midst of it all forgot to give me a call and reschedule for the show, so she's off the hook. These things do happen. Doesn't mean we're not going to give her a hard time about it, but she's off the hook technically. Okay, Bill, are you still here?
It's Mike.
Oh, Mike called in. Oh, good. Because, you know, with Bill...
I'll have what he's smoking. Hey, I got the commercial.
Good, good. I cranked it up a little bit extra for you so you get a good copy.
I'm going to make that your ringtone.
There you go. 50 cents for the... What? For the after
50 cents for the shaving cream, a dollar for the lotion.
Yeah, I like that. Okay,
so I looked all over YouTube for it and couldn't find that exact one.
Huh. Yeah, I downloaded, when I was looking for the retro ads, I downloaded a file and I think there's about 200 ads in there. And I just went through it and pulled the ones that I was most familiar with and put together four ads.
I noticed some new ones in there the other day.
No, I put together four ad blocks, each with about four ads, because they're about 4 minutes apiece, plus my bumpers on it.
Yeah, I'm sitting there poised with my phone over the record button, just waiting for the exact moment to hit the button.
Well, you don't need to do that. Just record the whole
thing. Well, then I can go back later and cut, the parts I don't.
Exactly.
From the beginning and the end and that.
Okay, let's see.
Got it. It's cool. Woohoo! Yeah!
Let's see. Carol says Bill has the headache. Then she says Tom is a headache. And Bill says Tom is a buttache.
Take that headache powder.
Can you feel the love in the room?
Oh Tom is God. A buttache.
And these are my friends.
Yeah, boy, with friends like that, you don't need no enemies.
You can imagine what the ones that won't call in were saying about me. Okay. So here we're going to, first I'm going to just run down the list of these different security agencies, and then we'll, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, see, Bill didn't want to call in because he wanted to sit up there in the cheap seats and throw rocks at you.
Well, yeah, it's a lot easier just to throw stones than to be put on the put on the hot seat and have to respond to anything. So I'm just going to read through the names first of all these agencies. The 25th Air Force, Intelligence and Security Command, the CIA, Coast Guard Intelligence, the Defense Intelligence Agency, the Office of Intelligence and Counterintelligence, the Office of Intelligence and Analysis, the Bureau of Intelligence and Research, the Offices of Terrorism and Financial Intelligence, the Office of National Security Intelligence, Intelligence Branch, Marine Corps Intelligence Activity, National Geospatial Intelligence Agency, National Reconnaissance Office, National Security Agency. Ooh, the NSA. Ooh. And the Office of Naval Intelligence. 17 intelligence agencies.
You know, Tom, you have to ask yourself, what would Jack Ryan think?
Jack Ryan would probably say, okay, put me in charge. That's what they all say. Put me in charge, and I'll fix it.
Yep, he'd be the Donald Trump
and theoretically,
of his day.
And theoretically, that's what the move was supposed to have done when they created a Director of National Intelligence. He was supposed to be in charge of all this, but they're still all reporting to different federal departments. So how can one person be in charge of all of them?
I have a question.
Yeah.
Are these people unionized?
Oh, you can bet on that.
Well, there you go, job security.
Yeah.
Job security for government employees is making government bigger. That's growing government is their job security.
Yep. And that
even FDR thought that unionizing government employees was a bad idea.
Oh, it's a horrible idea. And it should be an illegal idea. Because here's the thing. Here's the thing. If I own a business, and let's say you're the shop steward, there's a union out in my shop floor, you're the shop steward, and I want to do something, you're going to come to the table and negotiate with me, and you want to get a 5% raise for all the employees. I don't want to give any raises at all. We'll probably find a mean somewhere between 3 and 5 that you'll be able to live with. If I want to give up an extra 3% of my profits to pay the goons out on the floor, that's up to me. If I don't, that's okay too. You guys can go on strike. I'll hire non-union labor or bust the union altogether. But it's up to me because it's my profits. Now, if it's a corporation, I'm negotiating with the corporate board's money. I'm going to have to answer to the board. The board has to answer to the stockholders. So now it's a bigger decision. More people are involved in, do we do this? But it's still our money that we're talking about. But when it comes to public sector, when we come and talk about government employees being unionized, now it's the congressmen or the state employees. If
they get donations from the unions that sits across and does the collective bargaining.
Right, which basically means it's the Democrats that are negotiating with the unions. The Democrats give them everything they're asking for. They don't care because they're dealing with taxpayer dollars. They'll just raise the taxes. This is why people get paid $70,000 a year to deliver mail. Okay? This is what
happens. Until the chickens come home to roost.
Exactly.
And then they're, oh, God, we don't have the money to pay out to these retirees from the public sector unions. It'll bankrupt us. Well, you didn't think about that when you made the deal. Of course, those politicians who made those deals are long gone.
Long gone and retired, making probably 150% of what they ever did when they actually worked for a freaking living.
Exactly. You know, there's two seats at the bargaining table. The politician who gets the money from the unions and the unions. There's no chair for the citizens who pay the taxes.
Right. So you've got the politicians that are getting money from the unions, and you've got the unions that are getting money from the politicians. Wow. We'll give you a bunch of money if you'll give us a bunch of money.
The perfect symbiotic relationship.
Right? How perfect could it get?
So, for grifters.
So what we're looking at here is 17 agencies under several different departments. Some of them report to the Defense Department. This one reports to the Energy Department. That one to State. This one to Homeland Security. This to Treasury. This to Justice. So the reporting to several different departments, how they can all report up to the Director of National Intelligence is beyond me, because he doesn't control their budgets. He doesn't control their director. I'm not sure how that works, if it even does. But I found this one U.S. intelligence funding chart, which is rather interesting. It shows that the CIA is the biggest expense, money-wise, drawing $14.7 billion, with the NSA coming in at $10.7 billion. Now, the NSA is probably the most secretive of all. In fact, for years, NSA meant no such agency. The government denied that it even existed. But now there are rumors that its budget is actually three times. And these are off-the-books budgets. They don't publish them. So nobody really knows except a select few in Congress. But theoretically, it could be three times the size of the CIA, which we just said is at 14.7. So call that 15. Now we're talking $45 billion for the NSA. Now the NSA's primary function, and we're going to go through these in a little bit. We're going to go through the primary functions for most of them. But the NSA's, or at least for some of them, it was established in 1952 with a mission primarily dedicated to code breaking after the Allied success in cracking German and Japanese codes way back when. There are headquarters in Fort Meade, Maryland. The main functions of the NSA are signal intelligence, intercepting and processing foreign communications, cryptology, cracking codes, and information assurance, which is basically preventing foreign hackers from getting secret information. The budget is classified. Some estimate it's actually the largest intelligence agency in the world, three times the size of the CIA. The headquarters alone takes up 3 million square feet, about the same size as the Pentagon, and it's got 112 acres of parking spaces. Now that is a massive, massive organization. But here's the thing, their headquarters, as massive as it is designed to pick up and intercept every phone call made in the United States of America, every cell phone call, every landline, every email. We are no longer picking up foreign communications. We're spying on the very taxpayers that fund this behemoth. And that's a scary thought. Now, this chart that I picked up shows several of the top agencies. The CIA at 14.7, the NSA at $10 billion, National Reconnaissance Office at $10 billion, the National Geospatial Program, which I'm geospatial is the satellites, so that's a separate department. I don't know why they need their own department, but that's at $4.9 billion. And then it drops down to a couple more smaller ones, and then other at 4.5. The total of these is $52 billion. But as we just said, this has the NSA listed at 10, when in reality it's probably 45, which drives this 52 all the way up to $92 billion. $92 billion with only one correction on there. That's mind-boggling. And we wonder why? We wonder why it costs so much to run this government? Remember
a lot of waste and fraud.
Remember when Obama was running against it goes back to McCain, but even during Romney, they were talking about there are like four different federal agencies that rate and grade fish. Is it fresh seafood or is it saltwater? Two different agencies. Is it caught with lines or is it caught with a net? Two different agencies. And Obama was supposed to come in and trim some of this down. We've seen nothing. We did see some money savings with the, what do they call it when it's an across-the-board budget cuts, when they wanted to shut down the national parks and stuff. I forget what that was called, but and it was across the board. They didn't cut out unnecessary and redundant agencies. They just took, you know, like 3% across the board from everything. That way they could shut down national parks and the veterans couldn't see the veterans memorials and stuff like that. But nothing was trimmed. There was no bureaucratic cleaning up. We don't need a scalpel to clean this mess up. We need a chainsaw to cut this budget. And man, I would love to be the Donald Trump's director of making the government smaller.
Better get some C4 to at least loosen it up first.
Right? I would be the most unpopular man in Washington, D.C. Because I would come in and for years, the Heritage Foundation has done, and there's been a couple of other organizations, too, that talk about where government waste is. And it doesn't take a lot of research to go in, talk to a couple of these think tanks, see where they see the government waste is. There are lists of these agencies that are doing repetitious and duplicitous stuff. Just go in with a chainsaw and say, okay, this is shut down. Yeah, that's 500 people out of work. Sorry. But that's better than 500 people on a government payroll doing jobs that don't need to be done. So we're just going to let the duplicitous thing go, and then we're going to take the agency that's doing the job and we're going to cut it back by about 80%. And then we're going to let the other 20% convince us, you've got 90 days to convince us, that that agency even needs to exist. Because we're coming back around. There is so much government waste. The Department of Energy, the Department of the Interior, the Department of State Department needs to exist. There's so many. Department of Education, send this crap back to the states.
Well, Tom, Bill just posted a thing about HUD announces record grants to end homelessness. Haven't we had a war on poverty started back in Johnson, you know? I mean, trillions of dollars, and we still have poor and homeless.
Right, yeah, how's that?
And they're doing this, what, before Ben Carson gets in there?
Right, and how's that working out for us? They're going to have record everything going on just to cause mass confusion before Trump hits the office. We're going to see so much stuff snuck through in the next 29 days, it's going to blow your mind. Folks, stick around.
Rush, Howard, and Piven.
Right? Folks, stick around. We've got a lot more coming up right after this. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Wednesday morning with my good friend, Mike Nelson. Mike Rabbit Hole Nelson.
There you go. There goes another.
Watch out for
cigarette hangover.
That stale, musty, smoked-out taste in your mouth.
Cigarette hangover.
That tight, dry, uncomfortable feeling in your throat.
Cigarette hangover.
That's what takes the joy out of smoking. And when that happens to you, it's time to switch to Philip Morris. Remember,
over 2 million more smokers have switched to Philip Morris.
Yes, if you're tired of cigarette hangover, join the millions who have discovered in Philip Morris a milder smoke, a cleaner, fresher smoke than they've ever known before.
Over 2 million more smokers have switched to Philip Morris.
Remember, Philip Morris is the one, the only cigarette proved definitely less irritating, proved definitely milder than any other leading brand. No other cigarette can make that statement.
Remember, top-ranking doctors, eminent nose and throat specialists, actually suggest Philip Morris in cases of irritation due to smoking.
Above all, remember this. You'll be glad tomorrow you smoke Philip Morris today.
You'll be glad this winter you bought a Coleman heater this fall. Yes, as you sit back in your easy chair, snug and comfortable, you'll be glad you bought a Coleman heater. You'll enjoy floor-to-ceiling warmth in those rooms you could never heat before.
Get your Coleman oil or gas heater now during Coleman's big bonus sale. Here's what you get.
First bonus, a new low price.
Yes, now you can get a dependable Coleman automatic heater at a new low price.
Second bonus, a new low operating cost.
Coleman saves you up to 25% on heating bills because Coleman gives you maximum heat from your fuel.
Third bonus, a 32-piece set of Libby's Safe Edge glassware worth $14. It's free with your new Coleman heater.
Get three big bonuses. Get your Coleman oil or gas heater now during Coleman's big bonus sale. This sale is for a limited time only.
So see your Coleman dealer tomorrow. You'll find his name and address in your telephone directory.
Lum and Abner will be with us in just a moment, but first, a short message from the Ford dealers of America.
Owners everywhere are talking about the economy of the 50 Ford. Listen to what Mr. Jacob N. Wade of Lyndhurst, Virginia, one of over 420,000 delighted owners, said about his new Ford. In these days, when the cost of everything is up, it's certainly great to own a 50 Ford. For I found that my new Ford V8 gives me everything I'd expect to find in an expensive car for amazingly little money. And in addition to being a low-cost car to buy, I find my Ford is mighty economical to own. I get 20 miles to a gallon and spend very little for upkeep. My money sure goes a lot further since I've owned a 50 Ford. Yes, Ford owners everywhere are finding out about the economy of the great new Ford. They're saving real money now because of Ford's low price. And they'll be saving real money for years to come because of Ford's low operating and maintenance costs. But see for yourself. Tomorrow, stop by your neighborhood Ford dealers. Get the facts on Ford economy. Then take the wheel and test drive the big new Ford.
Every one of you undoubtedly has a headache or pain remedy that you swear by. But haven't you noticed that on some occasions it fails you? That there are times it does not seem to work? On these occasions, let me suggest that you try Anacin, for here is a remedy that I'm sure won't fail you. You'll find the fastest and most complete relief in Anacin you have ever experienced. The reason is simple. Anacin contains not one pain-soothing agent alone, but four, one of which is in all probability the remedy you now customarily take to relieve pain. You can get Anacin at your druggist for a few cents. Your money back if you're not pleased. I'll spell the name. A-N-A-C-I-N.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, brushless or lather, boys, whichever you can ocean.
50 cents for shaving cream, $1 for the lotion.
Old Spice means quality, said the captain to the bosun. So look for the package with the ship that sails the ocean. Yo-ho, yo-ho.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America, one voice, united we stand. I am America, one hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done. I will not rest until we won. I am America.
And we're back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Wednesday morning, a little disjointed, but it is us, and it is today. We're on the phone with my good friend, Mike Nelson. We're trying to do a conversation about our national security agencies. Meanwhile, the broadcast activists in the chat room keep trying to distract us by throwing up things like DHS gave the Muslims, Somali Muslims, security briefings and tours in secured areas at major U.S. airports. Yeah, there is that. We're going to see a whole lot of changes with this Muslim community here in the next 6 months, brother. You think?
Yeah, I think so. I think a lot of them said that if Trump gets elected, they're going to go back to their where they came from.
Well,
I wonder if they're going to be like these celebrities who made such likewise promises that if Trump gets in there, that they're going to move to Canada.
Yeah, right. We've seen how that has gone, right? Well, they still
Well, they're lying sacks. They never intended to begin with. It was all just hyperbole. Lies.
Well, first off, they didn't expect Trump to win, so it was a safe claim. Second of all, they are upset. They're absolutely livid that Donald Trump's president. They want to leave, but they don't want to leave bad enough to learn the metric system. So,
well, if they really want to know where their candidate would have taken them in the future, all they have to do is, why don't you move down to Venezuela for a year?
Right.
And then maybe you'll learn to appreciate what you had here in the United States.
Exactly. All right, listen.
And no, that's where Hillary would have taken us.
I want to run through two of these agencies with a little more detail than we've done, which is zero detail so far. The spy agencies. The nation's 17 spy agencies, including the CIA and the NSA, have an annual budget of $155 million. Many of the intelligence accounts are classified, so we can't really know the true total, but we do know that the budgets for the spy agencies have doubled since 9/11. The NSA has grabbed most of the attention of late with its plans to expand into their $2 billion data mining center in Bluffdale, Utah. They're set to launch in September of this year. This is an old report because they did launch the building. They're in it. Whistleblowers like William Binney have stated the agency is already spying on American citizens domestically. As the war with terror increases its scope through drone surveillance on American soil, the NSA's budget will only increase. With the increasing danger posed on large sections of the U.S. Constitution, the CIA is, of course, been long implicated using assassination rings to topple foreign governments and political opponents while being at the center of Guantanamo and rendition torture apparatus. Well, I've got no problem with either of those. But it's one thing to have these agencies focused on what's going on in other places. It's another to have them spying on my white ass, okay? This is totally unacceptable. I am not down with the whole Patriot Act about spying on us, on listening to my phone calls, which I know they do, on monitoring my email, which I know they do. I'm not cool with that at all. So then there's the Department of Homeland Security annual budget of about $100 billion. There's a 3,000-page PDF file that's online that you can download. Now, bear in mind, a ream of paper is 500 sheets. So this is going to be 3,000. That's 6 reams of paper if you want to print this out. That's a lot of paper. Much like the Department of Defense, the activities of the DHS are all-encompassing, including the goon squad of the TSA, which has employed untrained, low-IQ, and criminal elements, including pedophiles, to reach into the pants of men, women, and children. The TSA is also responsible for introducing cancer to its employees and the public through its backscatter radiation naked imaging machines. And now they're set to hit the streets across America with their spin-off Viper teams. The DHS has set up the ultimate framework for tyranny, including secret lists, secret arrests, activist surveillance, biometric immigration measures, control of cyberspace, Orwellian telescreens, and PSAs that increasingly portray average citizens, i.e. guys with radio shows. Average citizens involved in normal activities as worthy of suspicion and interrogation. They're ensured to be on the front lines of any gun control and confiscation measures. They're clearly stockpiling their own ammunition in ever greater numbers. I truly hope, brother, that Donald Trump trims back much of this inward, at least inward. I don't mind spending money for security on outward-facing agencies. Do you?
Now, as far as the Second Amendment thing goes, I've been reading or seeing news reports that California has passed some new law that for so-called assault weapons, limiting the magazine capacity.
Oh, that's been for years, yeah. No more than 5 rounds. In fact, I think it may be 3 rounds in California.
I think they're even doing away with detachable magazines and going to internal magazines.
Which is stupid.
Move out which of that state. I mean, my God.
Which is stupid because they cannot take away the weapons that you already have. All they can do is regulate what can be sold. So, with all the AR-15s, AK-47s, with all that is already in existence, trying to close it down now by saying no more guns that accept magazines can be sold within the state.
Well, the news report I saw said that they were interviewing some gun store guy and says that these people have to come in and actually buy the weapon by tomorrow or they fall under the new regulations and won't be able to get them.
Yeah.
And I guess there was people lined up around the block
and
trying to get in there and get their order in.
And they're going to
see, you know, so they could get in there before the deadline.
They're going to start where you have to register to buy ammunition. When you go in and buy it, you don't just pay for it and walk out the store. You're going to have to...
that was part of it. That was part of that report about the ammunition.
You're going to have to fill out a form. I'm buying ammunition. You're going to be limited to how much you can buy, probably 10 rounds or 20 rounds at a time, and that may be in a two-week period or something. They're just trying to do everything they can to make it as difficult as possible to own a gun, which was the primary driver for me leaving California. I lived in California for most of my life. And for them to tell me that I can't carry a gun, that was it. You know, when I finally got denied my carry permit some 15, 18 years ago, I said, that's it, I'm gone. And I packed up and I left the state. And I'm not going back and I will not go back. Brother, we're down to the final minute. What have you got? You can be about politics, or you can just, throw stones at Bill Perryman in the chat room.
he deserves it. Let me tell you,
right
in there throwing stuff at us. They're trying to get us all sidetracked. But I got to tell you, Tom. You know, I've got two pills here. One is blue and one is red. You take the blue pill and you wake up in your bed tomorrow like nothing happened.
No.
You take that red pill and you're going to find out just how deep my rabbit holes go.
I know what happens when you take the blue pill.
You do.
And if it doesn't go down in 4 hours, you're supposed to call a doc.
I was just thinking that.
Nothing. I'm going to call a hooker.
Brother. I know what they do when that happens. They took a needle and you can...
Ow.
Yeah.
Ow. Yeah, no. I'll call a couple of hookers before I call the doctor.
Yeah. Brother,
once again, brother, I want to thank you for taking the time out of your day on the spur of the moment to call in and be a part of the show, okay?
Yeah. Old Titanium Bill there.
Right?
So,
all right. God bless you and yours, America.
I'm going to be on tomorrow, right?
Yeah, Bill's on tomorrow. You bet. God bless you and yours, America. This is Tom O'Halloran and Mike Nelson. We are so, so very out of here.